a media and a radio station really give y'all the support that y'all needed in this city, as opposed to when you went to other cities, Atlanta, Chicago, the love that you got there, that you get that same love here?
Yeah, we got the same love. We got better love here. As you know, wherever you're from, you're appreciated as we know how you age. But for the most part, people have showed us love over the years. We got the key to the city, we got our own day, you know, stuff like that, that, you know, icons from the city that go across the country, across the world, and show what they can do. Even how it shows the people here, it shows the, I see it, I feel it every day, so, I mean, I can say that we get love here, I mean, definitely. There's no place like home, no matter where you go, love here is much better, you know what I'm saying, because it's more harder to please your peers than the people that surround you.
Well, let me ask you this question right here. Gerald Burke, the late great Gerald Burke. Tell us the impact that he had on your career.
Well, speaking for myself, I'm quite sure I can be speaking for Melvin. Gerald was very instrumental. I've always said that he was an instrument that God put in our life, you know, to take us places. He's a very big influence. He's our mentor. He's probably the closest person that I've lost in my life, as much as my family is that and whatever. So, you know, he was a very intricate part of just us. If it wasn't for Gerald, you know, God put him in our life, we wouldn't be here at the end of the time. So the world would have never heard the talents and the gifts that the Root Boys had to bring.
As I understand, you know, Gerald really is a person that a lot of people don't understand. And when I say that, I mean that because he was a private man. And if he let you in, he was in. And if you weren't in, you weren't in. I never disrespect you, never do any bad to you. But in his heart, if he got you, he got you with both hands. In both feet. You know, a lot of people understand that. And we can read, I'm telling you, George, tell you, Cleveland. Just we heard a lot of things that David Cleveland called, you know, these Root Boys did for what Gerald did. He called me at any given time. If he had in his pocket, it was ours. Whatever he had was ours. But at the end of the day, love is love. And talk is tough. But you know, a lot of people that envy what he was blessed to do, or envy what Gerald was doing, he envied his own. So it was all about poison. But he never poisoned nobody, man. He was always a proper guy. Whatever he had, he gave it to you. And the love was the love. And guess what? At the end of the day, it was all about the money.
I'm gonna throw a couple names out there, and y'all tell me what they mean, y'all. Like, we gonna say Eric B. Grant from the OJs.
Big brother.
Oh yeah, big brother.
Big brother almighty. Look, a lot of people don't know about Big B. I don't know how he's gonna think about this story. I bet y'all don't